Hello my fellow Minecraft engineers, my name is Rustash, and today I will be telling you guys to make a super duper easy item sorter in Minecraft 1.18 plus. Anyway, that is how it should look like right there, and as you can see, this is fully set up right here. And if I were to throw, let's say, 1, 2, 3 coal, 1, 2, 3, 4 iron, let's do 2 raw gold, and let's do 5 diamonds, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you can see, if I go right here, there's 5 diamonds, 3 coal, 2 raw gold, and 3 raw iron. And that's basically this entire mechanism. And just saying, before we get on to the tutorial, hey yo, it's FutureRustLash, and I'm just saying that if I'm going on a rant about something that you don't really want to learn, you could just skip that section, because there are multiple sections to this video if you just look in the play bar or in the description, and continue enjoying. And here are the materials. All materials are on the left side of the screen, and this design can go however long as you want. So let's say you're sorting 5.3 billion items, it will go that far if you have that many materials. So the first thing you want to do is we're just going to set up a simple chest system. So I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3, and 4. And as you can see, I'm just holding shift so it doesn't stick together. Now, if we just get our building blocks, I'm making it out of brown concrete powder, because I'm going to show you that even if you build it out of sand, a falling material, you can still build this design. And now, this is not really a necessary step. You can put any type of block you want as long as the chest's open. I'm just going to put stairs because in Java Edition, this can open. I know in Bedrock, if you put stairs over chests, they do not open, so this design currently does not work in Bedrock. At least I think. Tell me in the comments below if it does, because I really don't know. Moving on to the back right here, I'm just going to place hoppers facing into each one of the chests, and it should look something like this. Then what you want to do is on this section right here, just place more hoppers like this. And then to make our final hopper row, I'm just going to get done with all the hopper rows. You're just going to place a temporary block right here. This one cannot be affected by gravity, so it has to be floating. But since it's a temporary block, we're going to destroy it anyway. But after that, like I said, you just want to get a hopper. Just get on top of this, or you can just jump and just do this. Mid-jump, I'm just holding shift, but this one, you don't want to stop here, you want to stop right here. Alright, now you can just break this block and add an oak trapdoor, or whatever trapdoor you want. I'm just holding shift, right-clicking it, and it should look like this. Now, if we just destroy this block, destroy all of these blocks right under the first row of hoppers, I'm just gonna place redstone torches on this block, and this block. Make sure they're, like, on, kind of, what is this called? On top of, they're hanging off of this dirt block right here. Because if they're not, if they're like this, then we're good, then the redstone repeater system we're about to make will work. So once you have it hanging off of this block right here, just get your redstone repeaters, yes. Just skip the block that they are on and just destroy these ones. Now I just want to place 1, 2, 3, 4. They're all one tick. This is 1 tick, 2 tick, 3 tick, 4 tick. Make sure they're all on one tick and facing into this block right here. Now just place some brown concrete. And again, I'm using it out of brown concrete powder, because it can be made. Now, on top of the platform we just made, just go on top of it and get your comparators. You're going to be placing these right here. Nope, wrong one. And now, we're actually going to be right-clicking them again, so they have the little, like, red bulb thing on. Just connect everything up with redstone. I mean, super simple. And you should have a design looking somewhat like this. And as you can see, if we go to spectator mode, you should have your repeaters right here. You can't see them, but I guarantee you they're there. And then your comparators right here with your redstone torches just hanging off of this block. All right, now we can just build the water system. And I do recommend you be a little careful with this, because water does destroy a redstone, like, quite instantly. So just be a little careful. That's all I'm saying. Now what you're going to be needing is just some glass. You're just going to be building a 3-tall pillar just right here, and you're just going to be looking something like this. And just skip these two blocks and place a block right here and destroy this block. Get your fence gate. I'm just going to choose fence gates because it's easier. I'm just going to do this and just leave them open. Now get your soul sand. You should know, if you're here by the 1.13 update, that if you place source blocks on every single block, it should start being bubbly. Make sure it's source blocks, and if for some reason you are building this very high up in the sky, I recommend to get just one water bucket and just place it something like at the top right here, and then just get kelp and build off the sand block, because as soon as kelp hits water, it turns that water bucket into a source block. Now just build your pillar. Make sure it goes all the way around here, stops right at the trapdoor, goes over the trapdoor, and just keeps going. I'm just gonna build it all the way till here and just build a little up and place a water bucket right there. It's gonna travel all the way to here. And let's say, like, at the start of the video I said this can be however long you want. Of course, if it's gonna be like I think above 5 blocks or 6 blocks, I don't know, the water will stop flowing. Like, look, the water stopped flowing. An easy way to fix that is just get some packed ice, get some signs, and then get more water. I'm gonna build some glass. I'm gonna teach you how to expand this system. Just replace this trapdoor right here with glass, or sorry, packed ice. Then on that packed ice, put a birch sign, escape, so it's like this, and then continue your hopper array. Like, look, your hopper array is right here. You can just continue your hopper array. If there was hoppers, let's pretend these glass are hoppers. I can just place this. I can just place my water right here, and as you can see, it's gonna keep flowing for another, what's it called? How long is it? 7 blocks. And as you can see, instead of 4 blocks, I now made it, well, a lot bigger. Of course, there has to be sections because you can't put, you can't have this packed ice hopper because then the water will not go. But since this is just a demonstration for the tutorial, I'm not gonna make it that big. I don't need to make it that big. So I'm just gonna replace everything I just made with what I had before. All right, once you have this, we're gonna start adding our way to actually filter out each item from each other. So I'm just gonna get all of my materials, and we're gonna use these hoppers and these hoppers for the system. So I'm gonna make my first hopper with iron, my second with gold, my third with diamond, and my fourth with coal. Well, that rhymed. All right, so I'm just gonna place 18. So I right click this hopper right here, the first hopper. I'm gonna make this one, so basically this chest right here give me only iron. So I'm just gonna go right here and go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, all the way up to 18, and then get your random blocks. These can be dirt, whatever you want, and just fill them up. Do this the same thing with everything else. I don't know why it's 18. I think it's something to do with the picking up system, but if you didn't put 18, it would just pick 18 and then jam, really. So don't do that. Of course, you're still not done, because once you put it under the hopper you just place, so for example, this one's raw iron, just place one raw iron right here and then a bunch of blocks. And then do the same thing. See, this one's gold, just place one gold and then all of this. All right, so once you have it, you should have, you know, something looking along the lines of this, and then under that, like this. Basically what this does is this will make sure that only coal will go into this hopper, then it won't just collect here, it'll immediately go into here, because this will turn off. Allowing, because if you have a hopper that has a redstone signal going into it, that hopper is now cut off. But since this will turn off, activating these ones, deactivating this one, therefore causing this one to allow it to go in here. It's a lot of steps, but redstone does this quite quickly. So now, like I said, if I were to just spam my Q button and just randomly throw a bunch of items in, I don't know exactly how much items, but they're just gonna fly up, really. And then, as you can see, they're all gonna be here. Of course, you can do that, but if you want it to be a little more, just a little more efficient, I suggest do this. It's really simple, and it's literally the best thing to do. As you can see, everything is in here. And that thing that where it shot out super high, sometimes if you have a really big mechanism, it can, like, a bunch of materials can go on the side right here. And if you don't want that to happen, just place some slabs on top of it. And now you don't need to, I'm just placing a bunch of item frames with what I want because, well, it looks nice, and at least I know, so I don't need to rummage around through everything. I hope you enjoyed the super simple item sorter, and many people think item sorters are super hard, and having water and redstone is super hard. It's really not. This is like one of the easiest item sorter systems I know. Thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to leave a like and subscribe, and see you guys there. Bye.